whenever she does it, it always turns out really, like, heavy. So.
Okay, well, do you think you could do a better job?
Probably not. Markayla, have you seen the new guy at school? His name's Chris Greeny.
Dibs.
I saw him first. Plus, I've been thinking about getting a perm because I heard he has a thing for girls with curly hair.
Markayla, are you serious? You would look horrible with a perm. Besides, you don't stand a chance with him.
Did I hear y'all talking about Chris again? You know how I feel about you over-sexualizing my friends?
Hi there. One large cheese pizza with extra cheese. Here you go.
Don't you work for Papa John's?
Yeah, why?
Then why are you wearing a Taco Bell shirt?
Hey, have you ever considered getting a perm? I think you could really pull it off.
That's crazy. I was literally just telling my friend I should get one. I feel like I would look so good.
Yeah, for sure.
Thanks. Why did you do that? Is this pudding?
Yep, that's definitely pudding. Tapioca, to be exact.
So you mean to tell me that homegirl over here just exploded into some tapioca pudding?
Markayla, listen. No real person would ever suggest that you get a perm. There's something that you need to know.
Okay, I'm listening.
3 years ago, my brother Mark came back from a weekend hunting trip with his friend. He told me this crazy story about what had happened to them, but I didn't believe him.
Wait, 3 years ago today?
Yeah, I guess it is.
My brother Mick has been missing since that day. We never found out what happened to him. Do you know what happened to Mick?
Yeah, I think I do. Mark told me that him and a friend came across a suspicious man while hunting. Mark shot him, and the man exploded into pudding. Under the body, they found a portal leading to a pudding dimension.
I'm sorry, did you say a pudding dimension?
Yes, keep up. Anyways, when they got to the pudding dimension, they accidentally killed 3 tapioca people and were banished into a void by the tapioca elder. In the void, Mick and Mark learned that they were actually dead and were each given one last wish.
Okay, so what did they wish for?
Well, that's the thing. They agreed to wish to go home, but at the last second, Mick wished for a perm instead.
I want to go home.
I want a perm.
So let me get this straight. My brother's been stuck in a pudding void for 3 years, all because he chose getting a perm over coming home?
Pretty much.
Is he still there?
I mean, there's only one way to find out.
Let's do this.
Is that the void?
I think so. Let's go.
Mick?
More people? You're kidding me.
Can I have 1 minute, please? I haven't seen my brother for 3 years.
Hey, sis. How you been?
How have I been? You could have come home. All you had to do was wish to come home, but no, you wanted a perm.
Okay, I'm sick of this. Please, take him away. All he's done is talk about how good he looks with a perm for the last 3 years.
Hey, man. I thought we were friends.
You thought wrong. Listen, ladies. If you promise to take Mick far, far away from here, I'll grant you each one wish, and let you all go home.
Okay, deal.
You may now state your wishes.
I just want to see Mark.
I really just want to go home.
I want a perm.
Now, Mick? Mark?
Yes, I swear, it's a truth. And I owe it all to you.
Because I had the time of my life, and I owe it all.
Hey Siri, FaceTime Chris Greening.
Making a FaceTime call to Chris Greening.
Hey, I'm Michaela. I've seen you around school and I just wanted to show you this perm that I got because I know you like girls with curly hair.
First of all, how did you get this number? Second of all, I like girls with straight hair.